Now this is our second session. The first topic is about maneuvering. In your driving lessons, this is the most difficult lesson, maneuvering. What is maneuvering? Let's say this is your car, and you are driving along this road. And then you notice there is a big sign here, do not enter, road under construction, or it's under water, you cannot pass through. So you have to go back. If this is a wide space, you can just make a U-turn like that. Like imagine Santo Domingo Avenue, it's a wide road. So if you want to go back, you can just make a one turn. Now if the road is not as wide as Santo Domingo, it's a narrow road, you cannot make it in one turn, so you have to turn several times. You have to maneuver. Coming from here, you go around, you stop. You move backward, stop. Until you can make a complete turn. Pagpapawisan kang malapoy dito. And this is where you can really appreciate driving this modern vehicle, power steering vehicle. There are several ways to do this. Now, the first step is in maneuvering. You park your car as much as possible closer to the gutter. Just enough not to touch the gutter. So you have enough room to go around. And then clutch down first gear. Apply gas lightly but steady. You release the clutch slowly, slowly, and halfway only. Because in maneuvering, be sure you run slowly. And the only way to control the speed is not through the amount of gasoline, but through the way you release the clutch. So while releasing the clutch slowly, and you can feel that the car is now about to move, that's it. Do not release it anymore. So while the car is moving slowly forward, where do you turn the steering wheel now? You turn the steering all the way to the left, all the way to the left, all the way to the left, all the way to the left. Now you are reaching the gutter, so you have to stop. Since you are running slowly, how do you stop the car? Clutch down, brake, see? Now 1 meter before reaching the gutter, clutch down. You have still 1 meter before you touch the gutter. Before you apply the brake, you turn the wheel back to the right first. So meaning, coming from here, you run the car slowly, then still all the way to the left, all the way to the left. 1 meter before reaching the gutter, clutch down, turn the wheel back to the right, and then brake. So clutch down, turn the wheel back, brake. So that when you stop the car, the tires are now facing the right side. So coming from here, you turn still all the way to the left, all the way to the left. 1 meter before reaching the gutter, clutch down, balik sa kanan, brake. You have to remember that. Clutch down, balik ang mundo bela, brake. But sometimes as a new driver, you cannot even remember the sequence. The sequence is clutch down, balik sa kanan, brake. What do you do is clutch down, brake. Tapos saka mo pinabalik. Siyempre pag nakabalik na, hindi mo na maibalik dahil mabigat na ang mundo bela. So after stopping here, clutch down, reverse. Move backward slowly. Where do you turn the steering wheel now? Is it right or left? You have to turn the wheel back to the right. Because if you turn the wheel back to the left, you go back here. Oh, parang dito na naman ako ah. Parang walang nangyari. Now the reason why, you turn it to the right before you stop, so that when you move backward, you just proceed more to the right. So clutch down, reverse. Move backward slowly, there is more to the right, more to the right, yeah. And then, 1 meter before reaching the gutter again, clutch down, turn the wheel back to the left, and then brake. So when you stop, the car now is facing the side, clutch down first gear, tuloy-tuloy ka na. You are supposed to make it in 3 turns. 1, 2, 3. That is the basic way of doing maneuvering. But suppose you are in a hurry to go back. And for you are not willing to use this method. You want to go back easily. There is another way to do it. How? You can maneuver the car, but instead of the front that being turned, you turn with the back of the car now. Yung likod ang U-turn mo. There. Itong U-turn mo yung harap eh. You are using different technique, but the same result. Your intention is to go back. First method, like that, the year, back method of maneuvering. What's the first step? Front method, the first step is you park your car closer to the gutter. Back method of maneuvering, you park your car 1 meter away from the gutter, 1 meter, and then clutch down reverse. For the back of the car to go to the left, where do you turn the steering wheel? Lefty. Front method, you turn it left. Back method, turn it left also. Yeah. So clutch down reverse. Now the reason why you give 1 meter allowance here, when you move upward, the front of the car will be going that way. So pag nakasagad kayo na akit sa bangketa puno ng kotse, so you have to give that 1 meter allowance. Clutch down reverse. This is the back of the car, that's the front. Move backward slowly, then it's more to the left, more to the left, more to the left. Gaganyan yan. Yeah. 1 meter before reaching the gutter here, clutch down, then it will back to the right, and then brake. Yeah. So when you stop, the car is now facing inside. Clutch down first here, tuloy-tuloy ka na. So you are actually saving one turn. Here, one, two, three. Here, one, two. Dire-diretso ka na. So if you are ready to go back, you can do this back method of maneuvering. This is much easier to do, but simpler than the first method. Next. Let's say you are residing in Sampaloc area, where the roads are so narrow. If you pass along España, after Welcome Rotonda, you go to Quiapo, observe all the streets intersecting España, and you'll be surprised, alternate sila. Maluwag, masikip, maluwag, masikip, maluwag, masikip. Yeah. So if you are residing in San Diego, for instance, San Diego Street, masikip yon. So this is your car. You are driving straight, and then you forgot something at home, you want to go back. If this is a wider space, you can do the first method or second method. But the road is so narrow, ginanyan mo, sumakto na. Exacto. But you cannot remove that car anymore. So if you think the space is not enough for you to do the first method and second method, so this is another way. Third method. You look at the back of your car. Look for a big house where the door garage is not aligned with the gutter. So malaking bahay ito. That is the gate. This is additional space. So you can use this additional space. What you do? Clutch down reverse. Move backward slowly, slowly. And then, gaganon ko roon. Tapos, ibabalik ko pa rin. Or, if there is not enough room for that, you look for the nearest street sa kanto rito. So you just move backward like that. Pagdating sa kanto, iganyan mo yung kotse mo sa kanto, and then stop, tapos babalik ka na lang ito. That's another way. Next, student method of maneuvering. Ayaw mong gawin lahat yan. Ayaw mong ganyan, mahirap yan. Ayaw mong gawin lahat. So how? This your car. You want to go back? Kumikot ka na lang. Para wala ka na lang problema. But if it's traffic, it will take you 30 minutes to go around. And yet, your own intention is to go back here. So these are different ways by which you can do this maneuvering. You can even practice this in front of your house. Next, parking. As a new driver, this is the last thing you can master, especially women drivers. Sometimes, you are now driving around every day, going to the school, going to the office, and yet, when you want to park your car, you are afraid to do it. You are somebody that, pakipark mo nga, pakipark mo nga. Pagdating sa gabi, pag-uwi mo, natatakot ka rin pumasok sa garay. O sige, pasok na yung kotse mo na loob. So umaga, o ilabas na nyo, iyan, dala nyo sa kutsata. Ito ang mga mahirap gawin. parking and garage driving. If you park your car in front of Mega, inside Mega Mall, ang Mega Mall parking, ganyan lang sila. You just enter the parking area, papasok ka lang ganyan. O kaya gaganyan ka lang. This is diagonal parking. Like if you park the car in front of Santo Domingo Church, it is just a simple turning right or turning left. Diagonal parking yan. No problem to do that. But in your case, as a new driver, the last thing that you can master is parking between two cars or parallel parking. What is this parallel parking? Okay, this is your car. You are looking for a space to park in between. Nakita mo may space dito. So you have to park your car between two vehicles. But as a student driver, upon seeing this place, since you are still weak in calculation, sometimes you are not sure whether this space is enough for your car or not. So what you do, the first step is you stop the car in front of the vacant space. Tapatin mo yan. Tapos titingnan mo, kakasya ba ako? Kakasya ba ako? Kung isang nakatayo ka na, hindi mo pa alam kung kakasya ka. Bumaba ka. Pero 1 meter in front, 1 meter at the back is more than enough to park your car in between. Based on your estimate, there is enough distance. So class down first gear. You move the car slowly forward, slowly forward, slowly forward. And then stop your car parallel and even with this car in front. Parallel sila at pantay yung likod nila. Yung bumper nito, saka yung bumper mo, pantay sila, align sila. At parallel ang katawan nila. Not both bumpers, just the back bumpers. Kasi baka track ito eh. E mas malit ang coach mo. Pinipili kong magbalasan. Hindi pwede. Siyempre back bumper lang. And your minimum space is only 1 foot away. 1 foot. Okay. That is the preparation. And then, glass down reverse. Apply gas lightly but steady. Your realistic glass is slowly, 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 and upway only. So you can move the car backward. There. While the car is moving slowly backward, 1 meter after passing this car, remember this, 1 meter after passing this car, for the back of the car to go to the right, where do you turn the steering wheel? Right. So, coming from here, last down reverse, move backward slowly, slowly, 1 meter after passing the car, turn the wheel more to the right, 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 papasok yan. Now, if you keep on turning more to the right, more to the right, ganyan yan, diagonal parking yan, kailangan you have to turn the wheel back to the left. The problem now is to make it parallel. The question is, when is the proper time for you to turn the wheel back to the left? Timing here is very important. There is no definite rule about when to turn it back. But I will just give you some pointers. This way, hindi nakaganyan ka. Last down reverse. Move backward slowly. Slowly backward. 1 meter after passing the car, you turn wheel back to the right, more to the right, more to the right, more to the right, more to the right, gaganyan ka. Nakaganyan ka. Now, if this is the driver, you are looking at the back, 1 meter before reaching the gutter from the end portion of your vehicle. 1 meter. But you cannot calculate 1 meter from this point. So to make it simpler, this is the driver. This is the hood of the car. This is your windshield. As soon as your windshield glass aligns with the end corner of that parked vehicle diagonally, makikita mo yan eh. Nagtapat na sila. Itong windshield mo, yung sarapin sa harapan mo, that will align directly to this end corner of that parked vehicle, stop the car. tumigil ka. And then, you move slowly backward. That is the proper time for you to turn the wheel back to the left. So, bindu ka. And then, move backward slowly. There's it. Back to the left. Back to the left. Back to the left. Back to the left. Yeah. That's what now. So, reverse, right, left. That's all what you have to remember in parking between two cars. Reverse, right, left. Meaning, coming from here, clutch down reverse, move backward slowly, slowly. 1 meter after passing the car, you turn the wheel more to the right, more to the right, more to the right. 1 meter before reaching the gutter, or as soon as the visual glass aligns with the end corner of the taken, you start the wheel back to the left, back to the left, back to the left, back to the left, there. Like a partner. So it is just a simple three-step ways. Reverse, right, left. Kaya huwag kayong matatakot. Wala kayong tatamaan sa parking. As long as you follow the correct step. Reverse, right, left. Gagawin niya. Makupo mo yan. Ang dali-dali niya gawin. You just follow the procedure. Yatras mo lang. So that is how to get inside. Reverse, right, left. Okay? It's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. You want to go home. Your car is still parked in between. How do you move out from that space? Paano ka lalabas? Yan. Kung paano mo pinasok, ganun mo nilang ilalabas. Remember this. Nung pumasok ka, deluris, reverse, right, left. Paglabas mo, ganun din. Reverse, right, left, D. So, clutch down, reverse. Move up on slowly. There's your more to the right. More to the right. More to the right. Yan. Siyempre, pag malapit ka na rito, pag more to the right ka, ha, yung likod pupunta sa right. Itong harap pupunta sa left. Lalabas siya. So, clutch down, reverse. Move up on slowly. There's your more to the right. More to the right. More to the right. And then before reaching the car, the back, clutch down, back to the left, and then brake. Yan. Pag nag-back to left ka, nakaharap niya, clutch down first gear, tuloy-tuloy ka na. So the procedure in parking between two cars is the same as in moving out. Reverse, right, left. Kasi pag lumalabas ka, pag dinerin mo sa right, ang puno lalabas, basta lumabas doon, makakalusot ka na. Ang importante lang naman, lumabas ang ulo mo na hindi tatama doon eh. Yan. Basta lumabas na makakalabas ka na. So reverse, right, left. In the blackboard, if you are watching me, ang dali lang mo kanya. Reverse, right, left lang yan. Kayang-kaya ko yan. Okay? So we will teach you parking, ay parking, maneuvering parking. But we can only teach you a few minutes for every lesson. After several tries, nakukuha mo na. Okay, ha? Reverse, right, left. Pabulitin natin, ha? Ay, kayo na. Reverse, right, left. Natapos ka na ngayon. So you are now driving your own car. All alone. And then, you are planning to park your car in between. First time to do it, without instruction, an instructor seated beside you. As a new driver, you always memorize the lesson. Tatapat daw ako dito. Titignan ko daw ang kakase. Pagkase daw, apat di daw ako. Parallel and even with the car. And then, reverse down. Reverse. Ano ba matituro sa amin? Reverse right, left ba? Or reverse left, right? Yan. Nalituto ngayon. The correct procedure is reverse, right, left. Pero kumisyon after several weeks, hindi yata eh. Parang ang nangangalit ko, reverse, left, right. Hindi siya pupunta. Kasi pag right, dito siya papasok. Pag nag-left, lulubog ang pinto nito. Lumubog ang pinto. Epo! Ako, Diyos ko! Nagkamali ako! Yan, tumingin ka. Walang nakakita. Mabuti walang nakakita. So nanginginig ka, ha? Natakot ka, you raise your car, oh! You think you are lucky dahil walang nakakita sa pagkabundol mo. When you reach your garage, you look at your car, anong nangyari? Sinabi niya na, nakalusot ka lang dito, basta nag-dish yung dalawang kotse, siyempre pareho kayong masisira. Suppose you are the owner of this parked vehicle, and they accidentally bump your car, and you are not around. They did not even notify you. How do you feel about that? So please, in any situation, if you are not sure about your action, always follow the golden rule. Kung ayaw mo mangyari sa iyo, huwag mong ginagawa sa ibang tao. So, you get down from the car, you look for the owner. If after a few minutes waiting, hindi mo siya makita, so, para hindi ka nagigildi, you make a small no. I am Mr. Dela Cruz. I accident bump your car. I was trying to locate you. I could not find you. Anyway, I cannot wait the whole day. So anyway, my car is insured. This is my telephone number, cell phone number. Call me anytime. So ilagay mo sa windshield wiper niya yung notice na yun na ikaw nakapangga. At least, makakatulog ka. Ngayon, kung pagkaalis mo, lumipad, hindi mo nakasalanan yun. At least naglagay ka. Kaya huwag mong ipitin pa sobra. Huwag mong ipitin sobra para lumipad ka agad yan. O ngayon, kung namatay ka the next day, you are now entering the gate of heaven. You are in front of St. Peter. Boy, ang dami mong kotse binangga. Tinakbuhan mo lahat na, St. Peter, naglalagay mong notice, ikaw pinapalipad mo eh. Si St. Peter pa ngayon ang may kasalanan. Ngayon, point here is, pag nabangga kong ganyan, matatakot ka. Yan. Kaya dapat walang nangyayari. Magkakapobia ka ngayon. So ayaw mo nang mag-back in between. But you have to do this. So what you do, you want to avoid parking between two cars. So to avoid this, you wake up early. So when you reach your office, in front of your building, you are the first car to arrive. So araw-araw, unang-una ka. Parking between two cars. Akong unang-una rito. So isang linggo, maga mo nagigising. Ikaw unang-unang nato. But you cannot keep on doing that every morning. So the next day, nabuyat ka, na-late ka, may naunang nag-park sa'yo. Bako rin graduate ng social life. Aga-aga rin yung nag-iwisip. But still, you are the second car to arrive. Ganyan pa rin yan. Okay? Another car arrives. There. Yan ang kotse mo ngayon. It's 12 o'clock, pinapauwi ka ng anak mo. Paano ka na makakauwi niya? Eh, pinaipit mo yung kotse mo. So please, if you are the second car to arrive, do not park so close to the vehicle in front that you cannot go home anymore. Huwag kang tumututo kasi wala kang control dito. So if you are the second car to arrive, you always give enough allowance in front. Para kahit natutupan ka nung nasa likod, may malulusutan ka. Kasi ito, you can control the one in front, but you cannot control the next vehicle who is arriving. So, yeah, you give 1 meter allowance. It's 12 o'clock in the afternoon, you want to go home. But as a new driver, you always memorize the lesson. Maglalabas daw ako. Reverse. Right. Left. Paano ako makaka-reverse dito? Eh, wala namang lugar sa likod. Hindi yata na ituro sa akin ito, ah. Kailangan ko pang ituro yan. Anong gagawin mo para maka-reverse ka? You move the car forward, you transfer the space that you left in front, transfer it at the back, there. So, nandun na ngayon sa likod. Reverse, right, left na ngayon niya. Lalabas ko ka na, lulusin ka na. So, in parking between two cars, do not make an experiment anymore. If the space is limited, The only way to particle in between is like this. Kahit anong kasikip niya, mapapato yan. Papawisin ka sa kakaikot, pero mapapato. Hindi mo pwedeng paganyan. Dahil yan ang gustong ipaganyan. You can park using the front method, two car length ang pagitan. Kung dalawang kotse ang space, you can do this method. Yeah. But parking between two cars, in which only one car allowance, hindi pwedeng paganyan. This is the only way that you can park the car in between. Kaya huwag mo na subukan. Let's say, ayaw na ayaw mo talaga itong ganito, mahirap eh. Gusto ko talaga ito eh. Pero problema nga, one car lang nga, kung yan ang gusto mo, hindi gawin mo. Kaya, siyempre, hindi pwede. Ito lang ko'y nasa harap. Para mag-asa ka. That is the only way. Yeah. Ngayon, if you are a student driver, you always follow the correct procedure, step by step. Tatapag ka rito, gagawin ka rin, ganyan. Pero pag sanay ka na, pwede ka nang mag-skip ng step. Lalo na kung mahirap ang party. Let's say, pumunta ka sa Greenbelt, pinababa yung pamilya mo. Sige, mag-order na kayo habang naghanap ako ng party. Nagkapos na silang kumain. Hindi ka talaga makakita. Lumalaki ng mata mo. We experienced this in along the commercial area. Pero napansin ka, mayroon isang natira. Pero may nauna na. Umaatras na. Eh, talagang disperado ka na. Ang dati mo ngayon. Dati ngayon mo. Tapos huwag natitigil. Huwag natitigil. Titignan mo kung gagawin niya. Ngayon, kung may baril to bumaba siya, paano ginagawa mo dyan? Sorry. Hindi kita nakita. Yan. Ngayon, kung dahil gumanyan ka, umalis siya, okay yun, pinagbigyan ka niya. Pero kaya mo lang ginan yan, just to hold that place. Pag wala ng matras, lalabas ka pa rin. Ganyan mo pa rin ipapasok. Kaya mo lang ginan yan, para wala na magka-interest na sa order mo. Tapos, pag wala nang interesado, ilalabas mo rin. Pero pag ganyan pa rin ang pasok. So pag mayroon pang pagi, ganyan mo kagad dyan. You are lucky if you can still do this. At in Makati commercial area, you cannot even do this. Babay kasama mo, maghahanap siya ng bakit. Tapos tatayo siya rito. Sabi nito. Alis kayo niya. Ganyan kahirap ang parking. Why? Kasi ang Pilipino ayaw nila magbayad ng 30 pesos, ayaw nila magbayad ang umakyat sa sport floor parking. Yeah, just to point that. Yeah. So kailangan, you have to park your car sa mga balulubla, sa mga, even if you pay 30 pesos, sometimes, is cheaper and safer that way. So that's all about parking and maneuvering. I think that will be all for this lesson. Okay. Next. Now, last meeting, we were not able to finish parking. Backing, the number one problem in your case as a student driver against the steering wheel. Nalilito kayo. Imagine your car, you are driving the car forward. In moving forward, you want to go left, you turn the wheel left. You want to go right, you turn the wheel right. How about the moving backwards? Suppose you want the back of the car right, where do you turn the steering wheel? Is it the same as in moving forward or opposite? Okay, ito ang drawing natin yan. This is your car. The tires at the back are just running straight. They are not moving sideways. The tires in front are the one moving. Okay? Use it to first gear. You move forward. You turn the wheel right. Saan pupunta yung kotse? Right. You shift to reverse. You move backward. You turn the wheel right. Saan pupunta?